Thai Yai.
Thai Yai?
Half Thai, half Myanmar.
So it's a mixed temple here. Maybe he can explain it. I am a little bit outside of Mae Hong Song and I'm trying to find the major attraction that Mae Hong Song town has to offer. I think it should be somewhere around here. Maybe it is here. Yeah, this is a bamboo bridge, the longest bamboo bridge in Thailand, and a beautiful temple. I'm looking for the bamboo bridge. The bridge? Bamboo bridge? It's here. I can park the bike here. Surprisingly, there are a few things to do as a tourist here. Check that out. So we have a temple over there. And here we have a rice paddy. And throughout this rice paddy, we have a huge bamboo bridge. Sawadee krap. Oh, you have wine here. Wine, oh, I don't drink much wine.
Tea?
Taste?
Yes.
Can taste? Okay, maybe neat noi. One try.
Strawberry or
strawberry. Oh, strawberry.
Strawberry.
Oh, we have another wine testing here. Maybe you remember like 2 weeks ago I did some wine testing somewhere in the mountains. Have alcohol? Because I need to drive. It's just a little bit. Very sweet. I like it, aloy. How much you sell these bottles for?
I need 300.
300 for one bottle. But it's not your wine, right? You buy it? Want to find out if it's his own brand, but I guess it's not his own brand.
Vodka.
Vodka?
Strawberry, linji.
Oh, okay. I think he's calling for help. And by the way, it's looking... Oh, it's not looking like it. It's actually raining again. Well, maybe I'm staying here and having some wine. Hello, sawadee krap. I'm just curious if the brand is his own brand or does he buy the wine bottles?
I'm not brand. That's not brand.
Not a brand. Or you buy the wine?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I think I have to stay here for a while. I got offered a little chair here because it's not looking like it's just a short shower. Actually pretty heavy now. I have an idea now. It's still raining, but I've been waiting for over half an hour here now and I will not let the rain stop me from enjoying and seeing this bridge and the beautiful temple. So luckily someone invented umbrellas. So we'll just use the umbrella now and walk this bamboo bridge and check out this temple. I come back later. Later I come back. I go temple and then I come back for wine. Okay.
Okay,
Theo. Yeah, I just decided when I go back, I'm gonna buy a bottle of wine from this man because he was actually really nice. Offered me a chair. Also, we talked a bit off camera and I actually feel a little bit bad for businesses like this. Sitting around here all day and I can't imagine that there are more than a few people coming by here a day. First, let's check out the bamboo bridge. And yeah, at the end of this bamboo bridge, we have a temple. And yeah, this temple at the end of this bridge is also the reason that this bridge exists. It was built for the monks so that the monks can go from the temple to this village. And yeah, I actually read that this is the longest bamboo bridge in Thailand. But it doesn't look that long, and maybe you remember from, I think it was the second road trip episode, where we've been to the bamboo bridge in Pai, and I think that was even longer maybe. And you know what? It's not raining anymore. Check out the bright sky over there. Whew! So, don't even need the umbrella anymore. But oh, that looks amazing. Look at all the foggy clouds over there. Oh! Damn it, my umbrella just fell down here. I was placing the umbrella here to record a scene here, and now the umbrella fell down. How do I get back my umbrella now? That is like 2 meters deep here. I think I have to go to the end of the bridge and then walk here, which will probably be pretty muddy now because of the rain. Yep, I no longer have dry shoes. But okay, this umbrella, I'm carrying this umbrella actually since I arrived in Southeast Asia. August 2019 is when I got this umbrella in Bangkok. So it is something I don't want to lose, you know? If you're stuck to an item, you want to keep it. So I will not leave it there. And yeah, I think this works here. Now you can even see how high the bridge is. I am 1.90 meters and the bridge is a little bit higher, so almost 2 meters. Ah, there it is. All right, got my Bangkok umbrella back. That was worth the wet shoes and socks I'm having now. And you know what, guys? What is really important when you are traveling or in life in general, you need to have the right mindset. And of course, I could have complained now about the rain, and it is literally raining every day on this trip so far. And yeah, most people probably would complain about it, but you know what? I don't complain about things I cannot change, because I don't want to waste my energy complaining about things I have no control over. I mean, complaining about the rain will not make it stop by any means. Just because you complain about things, you cannot change them. 30 minutes later, the sun is out again, and I'm going to enjoy this bamboo bridge and visiting the temple after rain. Don't complain about things you cannot change in life. That will make your life a lot easier in many situations. So just stay more positive. So we have a few stairs here to climb to check out the temple. And I do think that this is not Thai writing. This is Burmese writing, or Myanmarese writing. How do you say that? This is writing from Myanmar. Pretty sure about that. So probably this is not a Thai temple. It's a Burmese temple, I think. Oh, here you can see the bridge over there. We just walked over the rice paddies. Surrounded by some mountains. Lovely again, right? Wow, awesome, right? Check out the mountains here again. Wow. I don't get tired of the views here in Northern Thailand yet. It is absolutely stunning to see views like this on a daily basis here. Ah, you can get water here, but no one here to sell it. But I think probably this sign means 20 baht. Probably I can take it and then put the money in here. I think that's how it works. Let's see, I do have a water with me, but an ice cold water would be much better. So, okay, let's get a water. Water, and actually I need a small break now after climbing the stairs. Oh, you know what's the best drink in the world? Ice cold water when you are thirsty. What a great place, right? Yeah, this place was literally the first thing that popped up on Google when I was searching for things to do in Mae Hong Song. So I think this is not a hidden gem here. But yeah, sometimes it's worth to visit these touristic areas, because they are touristic and popular for a good reason here, right? Ah, check this out. They're using old tires here to build something. What are you building here? No English? Ani ne arai kap? Yang lo. What are you trying to build here? I can come here? Okay. Sawadee kap. I would like to know. Maybe he can explain it. That would be nice. Can you explain what this is?
Ah.
Ah, for meditation. Ah.
Meditation.
Okay. Ah, meditation stones. Okay. I get an idea. Okay. Every place here is for meditation?
Chai.
Ah, okay. All right. Very interesting. Nice to meet you. Thank you. Oh, okay. So they're using these places for meditation.
YouTube?
Yes, I make YouTube videos.
Your channel?
I can abroad.
Sit down.
You want to check out? Okay.
I'm from?
I'm from Germany.
Oh, Germany.
Chai. Ken? K-E-N?
K-E-N?
Can abroad, yes. That's me.
Your channel. Oh.
Cannebrod, yeah.
Follow you.
Oh, thank you very much. Kap Kung Kap. Is this temple Burmese? Because I think the writing is not Thai, right?
Thai Yai.
Thai Yai?
Yeah. Half Thai. Thai Yai. Thai Yai. Thai half Myanmar.
So half Myanmar, half Thai.
Yeah.
So Thai it's a mixed temple here.
Thai Yai. I'm Thai. Thai Yai.
Okay. So you are Thai.
Thai.
And everybody here is Thai?
Thai Yai.
Thai Yai. Thai Yai. And you live here, right?
Yeah. I live here.
Oh yeah, I drive with motorbike.
Hmm?
Yeah.
Where?
Oh, it's down here.
Where?
Parking here. Yeah. How many tourists come here? You have tourists come here many times?
Nitnoi. Because COVID.
Oh yeah. Okay. But before COVID, more people come here?
Many.
Oh, I can imagine. This is a lovely place, a popular place.
Come on.
Oh, you want to show me something? Yeah, so this I thought it's Burmese.
Thai Yai language.
Thai Yai.
Thai Yai language. Thai Yai language.
Thai Yai, okay.
Thai language.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, Thai language.
This Thai, okay.
Thai language. This Thai Yai language.
Okay. Oh, interesting.
Yeah, this
How long are you living here already?
1 month.
1 month?
Yeah.
Ah, so you are new here. All just moved in.
Chiang Mai.
Chiang Mai, you're from Chiang Mai.
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
I go to this here.
Uh-huh. Okay.
This way.
This way?
Yeah. Okay. Amazing.
It's a good way to check out? So I can walk all around?
Return.
Okay.
For you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah.
Have a good day. Bye-bye. Oh, lovely. First time I was actually speaking with a monk here in Thailand. Interesting. And he recommended me to check out this place. Looks a little bit scary, but let's check it out. Ooh. This looks more like going into a prison cell, right? So I walked around the whole temple area now. It is a huge area, lots of beautiful things to see. You see all the monks are smiling the whole time. That is so nice to see. Really enjoyed it. And yeah, this is what happens when you keep a positive mindset. I could have gone home. I could have called it a day when it was pouring down on me, when the rain was really heavily. But I decided to wait, stay positive. I even started to venture out when it was still raining, exploring the bridge. I wanted to see the bridge and the temple, so I kept my positive mindset and I ended up meeting really awesome, friendly people, seeing beautiful views, a nice temple. So stay positive, guys. Keep your mindset right. And now let's go back to this wine cellar and give him some business. Hello. I want to get a wine bottle.
Why?
Oh yeah, you said 300, right?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Then one strawberry wine.
Strawberry wine.
Yes. Kap Kung Kap.
Kap Kung
Kap. Have a good day. Bye bye.
Yeah.
So I don't drink wine. I don't really drink alcohol at all at the moment. So I will probably give this wine bottle to, I don't know, maybe the housekeeping ladies at my hotel. And thanks a lot for all the positive comments on the previous episodes, the first one of the road trip. Really makes me happy to read that you enjoy watching the series so far. Thanks a lot, Team Abroad. And yeah, stay healthy, stay positive, and then see you on the next one. Ciao, guys.